Let's go ahead and start building out our custom build. So we're going to start with the turret guns, which are going to be 2 size 2 distortion repeaters. And then we're going to get 2 size 1 neutron cannons. Then we're going to rock the FR-66 as well as the Shimmer. A lot of people like the Shimmer and the Palisade. And the reason for this is the Shimmer makes your shield regen really quick and the Palisade is high health. I do want to point out that after I finished this video, people were recommending the Palisade and Mirage. So those are both size 1 shields. Palisade and Mirage for size 1. And I'm going to talk about shield mixing. So you're like, why would you pick a shield that has less health? Well, the Shimmer is really good at recharging really, really quick. And the FR-66 is really stable. So with shield mixing, it literally just gives you the best of both shields. So now you have this high health shield that also regens really quickly. If you want more information on the shields, go ahead and click that I at the top. You can do this in all components. We're not going to cover this right now, but if you want more information, just click there. Next, we're going to talk about the power plant. You can see that now we are over our usage, so we're going to go for the endurance. And the reason for that is the Brenton is currently bugged and it's a lot more expensive. So boom, you see we're only using about half of our power usage now. And our coolers are still doing great, so we're not going to touch our coolers. And we've completely upgraded the ship for about 110,000 UEC, which is money you can grind out in a couple hours. So now you can see we've almost tripled our DPS, we've added 2,000 health to our shields, and we have doubled the shield health regen. So this is a big difference than our default. As you can see, this is our default, and this is our custom build. So big difference. You can click between those tabs and see how
that wreck. Xeno threat's been raiding these debris fields, so there's a good chance they're still on board. Be careful.
you come here, you look at the yellow button right under the crate and you use F and press, yeah, like that, and we're gonna take them out.
Just a heads up if you've never moved Zeta Prolidite before, that timer on the box tracks the mineral's decay. Make sure you deliver it before the timer runs out, or the mineral's useless.
Is empty, man, so you're good to go. Okay, so I'm good.
status on those deliveries?
Thank you.
I know someone saw that.
Robert's not done here. Booked to the AO. CDF recommends checking in with the medical staff at the rest stop before heading out. That way, we can have you covered if anything goes wrong.
Subject, we got a camp spill. Episode, I'm going to show you how to use the tractor beam on the pyromethic. So to get started, we're going to take a quick look at what this is. If we go to our equipment and click on utility, you can see here I have my multi-tool equipped and I've attached the true hole tractor beam attachment. That's right, we're sitting in 3.12 or 3.12. We're going to have some fun with the tractor beam. So we're going to pull out our gadget by clicking
tractor beam and start. Alpha 3.12. If you are loading into the game for the first time, I recommend starting in Area 18 on ArcCorp. The habitation unit you spawn into is very close to a Cubby Blast store where the tractor beams are sold. Once you enter the game, exit the habitation unit and head for the elevator. Then, select ground floor.
The threat just jumped a Navy supply convoy. Need combat support scrambled immediately.
On the ground floor, head for the exit. You will see a sign that says ammo. Go towards that, and you will come to Cubby Blast, a firearms and armor dealer. Inside, you will find the trade kiosk. You need to buy two items. First, under the weapons section, you must purchase the Pyro RYT multi-tool.
I need something for maintenance to get the ventilation control. Ping me when you get there.
You will then see an attachment subslot. Here you will attach the tool tractor beam. Save changes and you're ready to go. Thank you for watching. If you are new to Star Citizen,
actually is, but numbers can be tricky, so let's jump in the game and do a live test of what this actually looks like inside Star Citizen. So what we have is Admiral Bongo here. He's going to shoot my shields all the way to about one health, and we're going to see how long it takes to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 seconds it takes for it to even start regening, and then 11 to get to full. So that's 11 seconds that you're a sitting duck, basically, if you get hit again. So we're going to do the same thing with this one. He's going to shoot the shields all the way down to one health, and you can see it's going to start recharging instantly, which is already a huge, huge difference. The default having a 6 second delay, 5 seconds to get to full, and an 11 second total time, versus the upgraded that has no delay, a 4.5 second to full, and a 4.5 second regen time. That is a massive difference when you're in combat. Now, let's do a weapons test. Now, before we get into this, I just wanted to point something out because a lot of people are going to ask, why does your crosshair and pip look like that? Well, what this is this is an easy components guide to 3.8. Today, we're building a battle Mustang. Now, you can use this guide for any ship, but we're using the Mustang today because a lot of people don't have faith in the Mustang, and I want to change your mind with a couple of components. So what we'll do is we'll do a custom build and a default build, and we'll put them head to head and test out the major differences. So we're going to head to Urkel.games. It's in the bio. Go ahead and click that link, and I want you to follow along with me. The reason why using this website is so important is because a lot of this information is not in the game, and it's updated every single patch. I'm also leaving a link in the bio for a really helpful spreadsheet that has components, locations, prices, so make sure to check that out. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to click Change Ship, go to Consult.
Quantum travel complete. systems enabled.
Thank you.
begins now. All systems operational. All systems disabled.
Yo. I don't know. Hello. Alright.
Welcome. Your journey begins now. All systems operational. Your journey begins now. All systems operational.
Yo, bro. Yo.
Hi. Welcome.
Yo, bro. Yo, 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 yo.
Someone from accounts, please contact management. Accounts, contact management. Thank you.
I see Dooley here. Need more Acrylplex. Navy says they haven't been getting shipments of that.
Welcome. Your journey begins now. All systems operational. Launch complete.
Thank you.
fighters scramble to support some supply ships inbound to Jericho. They just got ambushed by Xeno threat and need help. To inform you that the Navy is good on stores of Dynamex. They want us to focus on the other supplies for now. We're over the hump, people. Let's keep those supply drops coming. We've got a good flow of supplies coming in. Navy's almost got everything they need. For a cap ship heading towards Jericho Station. came out of QT at Jericho. Weapons free, y'all. If he just updated me, Javelin's on the move. Heading back out to fight. Thank you. Dewey here. Appreciate you volunteering. We got Xeno's fed on the back foot, so we need to hit them now. I've set the details, so head on out as soon as you can. Dewey out.
Welcome to
down. Focus fire while you can. Threat interest destroyed. Great job, everyone. Hold up, hold up. Got more contacts coming in hot. Watch your fire!